Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video. Welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel for the newcomers. My name is Didi. Yes, to be or not to be, that's what we talk about in this channel. Short TA update because I don't have a lot of time. I need to prepare for two presentations I need to do tomorrow in Playa del Carmen. So let's quickly jump into the charts. Please watch till the end because the last three charts, amazing charts. You need to see them. Let's go. Bam. This ain't easy, darling. Let's go, Joe, go. Well, what the fuck is that? Let's go, Didi. Okay, 4-hour chart. It's like almost a movie my kids saw. Dora, Dora. Nah. 4-hour chart. Yes, we are in a long, short flag that could have told you to exit the long with a profit, of course. There is also the opportunity to stay into this long till there is a red candle closing down below the yellow stepping line. That didn't happen yet, so you could still be in the long, but profit is profit. So if you want to have the same strategy every time again, then you exit at the short flag or you exit at the closing of a red candle down below the yellow stepping line. So that is still very clear. Now, next chart. Bam. Here, this is also the 4-hour chart. This one is on TradingView. You see this downward like resistance line. Every time we try to break that line and we don't succeed, we did succeed today. We succeeded at around 4 a.m., I think, and then we are now retesting that line. So we are going a little bit sideways, and from here we should go bounce to the red line and then break this red line. This red line is like you can see, the resistance at the moment over here, and we need to break that one, retest that one also, and then take it up like that. That should be a very healthy move for Bitcoin, but let's see if Bitcoin has enough power and volume to make that move. And that is what you can see on this monthly chart. In the monthly chart, this orange line is a 12 moving average on a monthly time frame. We did close the month of November with a red candle, which means we opened higher than we closed. We opened at 61,356 and we closed at 56,900. So that gives you a red candle. The new candle opened now, and that is a green candle at the moment because we opened at 57 and we are now at 57,400. So this green candle, this December candle, that is going to be a very important candle. Yes, if we look back to 2013, I'm just showing you that candle over there, the one candle that was the November candle of that year, that pumped all the way from that midline, that green midline of the logarithmic growth curve, bam, to the top in 1 month. Then the December, we had a correction. Now in 2017, it went a little bit different. In November, we pumped a little bit. December, we pumped even more to the top. So we needed 2 months to reach the top. So I'm not saying that we are going to pump this candle to the top, but it is always possible in Bitcoin. And the top now is around $140,000. Let's see. There is three charts that you need to see to understand where we are at the moment and what could happen. And if you looked at the bottom of this, then you can see that the RSI formed every time again a double top here. There, you can also see the double top during the bull run in 2017. Now, we had a single top. We expect to have another top. And then this one should be going up like that to make that top and then come down again. Okay? Everything, in my opinion, still okay. Now, let's jump into those other charts that you need to see. And bam, over here. Yes, I will keep it really short today, guys. This is an amazing chart. On this chart, you can see something really cool. You can see the, let's call it the supply shock. And you can see the colors are representing the stage that you are in. I found this one on Twitter, Alpha Beta Soup, I think is his Twitter account. I don't know for sure. But you can see the price weakness. That's the green area, which means the price is going down. But you can see that the strong hands are stacking. So they are buying. The strong hands are buying while the price is going down. And at that moment, you can see that there is bullish divergence because of the orange on the bottom of the chart. What leads into this huge run in the price, that red area, the red line. We go all the way up. Then again, the same happens. The price is going down. people with strong hands start to buy. Again, at that moment, we had at the down the bottom of the chart bullish divergence, and what happened? Bam, the price went up to that 68K level. Now we see again, we see the price going down. We see even a stronger accumulation from the strong hands. And again, we have the orange on the bottom. So what do you expect that the price is going to do? I think we will see a huge pump in December. Pump December, whatever you want to call it. Really cool chart. Bam, this is another amazing chart. This chart is the Bitcoin supply held by entities chart, which means how many Bitcoins is held now by entities with 1 to 10 Bitcoins. That one created a new all-time high today. We have now in total 1,649,369 Bitcoins that are held by entities with 1 to 10 Bitcoins. It's a new all-time high. These are not the whales. These are the people, maybe like you, that has 1 or 2 Bitcoins and all the way to 10 Bitcoins. In total, 6 million, I was thinking of something else, I think, 6 million, but 6 million Bitcoins are held by these entities. And you can see in the yellow line, that is a new all-time high. Very positive. In my opinion, that means that also the small hands are starting to accumulate more Bitcoins and hold them longer. One more chart, bam, because if we look at this one, we can understand how small Bitcoin is, and that we are talking about a very small market cap, which would mean that there is more, a lot of upward movement in the price possible. And how can you see that? Here, this very small dot on the left bottom, that's Bitcoin. It's a $1 trillion market cap. Gold is this bigger yellow dot. That's a $12 trillion market cap. Commercial real estate and agricultural land in total is a $65 trillion market cap. 33 and 35, so it's 68. Then we have equities, $109 trillion, the blue one. Then we have the top fiat currencies. That's in total $122 trillion. And then the debt securities, $123 trillion. And then we still have the residential real estate of $258 trillion. If you like take all those trillions together, and only 10% of all those trillions will flow into the Bitcoin market cap. And we would take Bitcoin by doing that to between 12 and 30 trillion US dollar. Do you understand what that means for the Bitcoin price? There's only 21 million Bitcoins. And if all this money, a small part, will flow into the Bitcoin industry, that can only do one thing, and that is increase the price level of Bitcoin, because there's only 21 million Bitcoins in total. Now, I hope that was all very clear. If that all was very clear, and if you like the charts, please give this video a thumbs up, share with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and please leave a comment. What do you think about these charts, and what do you think that the December target for Bitcoin will be? Do you think we can reach 100K? Let it know down below in the comments. Thanks for watching, and see you tomorrow again. Bam.